engaged. Now, can you imagine when ladies have when coming up, you know you're going to get married, the plan starts, you start to meet with your girlfriend. You start to call this one, you, what color you want in the wedding, you even spend what you don't have.
Yes.
You know you don't have so much money, but you have your plan reaches that $250,000 wedding. Or even a $500 wedding, $5,000, or $500,000, and you know you don't have so much money. Now Mary, she was preparing herself, and about to reach the big day, which is to get married, her dream, she was waiting on this for a long while. Didn't she know that the process was near? A lot of us in here, we're waiting on a big moment, and we're waiting just to make a change in our life. We're waiting, we're wondering when the change will come. So we're struggling so long and we want a change.
Yes.
I need you to know that before the change comes, there have to be a process. There have to be a process. Now Mary, she was there, and Mary, she was waiting on that process. She was waiting on her husband, and the process came. The husband proposed to her, and he was just loving her. He was just loving her, he was all into her. Wait on the big day. You know those men, when they get married, they can't wait on the big day, which is a big night. But little Mary, Joseph, he went to look for Mary. When he went to look for Mary, he saw Mary. And he realized that Mary normally would wear some nice, fitting clothes. And he realized that Mary's blouse started to get big. Mary started to get quiet. As he keep on looking, he realized that Mary's belly started to grow. A lot of men here, you are supposed to get married to a young lady. And before the wedding time, you realize that the belly started to get big. You know how someone would react to that? Someone is not staying there. But guess what? That was not it alone. When the belly started to grow, I can imagine Joseph went to her, and Joseph was asking her, who is the father? Joseph might, it might be a time Joseph went on the road and saw she talking to Robert. So Joseph said, look here, I'm Robert's the father. But that was not it. Mary now turned around talking to Joseph. Because I'm not a fact, my wife couldn't tell me that.
Yes.
The child that I have inside of me is of the Holy Ghost. And she tells Joseph, I'm still a virgin.
Oh,
I know a lot of you, 90% of you guys, which 90? 99, you're not accepting that. Holy Ghost. So Mary had a process, and she had to go through the process. So Mary was there, and she explained to Joseph that that child is of the Holy Ghost, Joseph. The child is of the Holy Ghost. Joseph, he was not taking that. He was not taking it easy. Joseph, he sticked around because I think that he was a good man. And he did not want in those days for them to stone her. So he stick around her because he loved her. But at times, Mary would be there with a big belly and everything, and she said, Joseph, I feel it. Can't rub the belly, not just say, nah, rub that. Instead of rubbing that belly. But he was there. And I can imagine when she had the cramps, because I've been watching my wife when she was going through the pregnancy, and I can tell you everything that goes on.
Yes.
And she had the cramps, and sometimes the foot, and the one, somebody to rub the foot, Joseph, and not rubbing that foot.
Yes.
Now she was going through the process. Before the wedding, a lot of friends and her family, her mom and her dad, everybody, I can figure they were there for her. But they could not take the disgrace, they could not take it. So I guess she was on a lonely road. That the process is a lonely road. She was there, you can imagine they were talking to her in the neighborhood.
Yes.
She said, you want to see Benji, daughter? Benny? And Joseph said, you want the father? Now, I don't know if the neighborhood got the news that the child was of the Holy Ghost. Because the neighborhood would not buy that either. Now, she had a process to go through. She conceived the Holy Ghost inside of her. And most times we believe that when we are saved and we have the Holy Ghost inside of us, the process will be easy. Can I tell you something? It won't be easy.
Come on.
Because the devil, he don't pay mind to persons who he know is not a threat to him. Mm. But persons who are dangerous and know that they have potential to reach farther, those are the persons the devil pay attention to.
For another person, you're going through your life and everything is smooth and rough, you're not important.
Yes.
If you're going through life and everything is smooth, the devil is not troubled by you.
Yes.
But when you have a purpose, the devil is out for you.
Yes.
You ever hear yourself walk on chalk line?